So good morning, and first of all, I wish to thank you for your interest in our study. On behalf of my co-authors, I will briefly present the results of our meta-analysis of randomized studies aiming to evaluate the role of hormonal agents called luteinizing hormone releasing hormone agonist, or LHRH analog, as a strategy to preserve ovarian function and fertility in young breast cancer patients. Breast cancer is the most common tumor type in women of reproductive age, with 11% of all breast cancer diagnosed every year in women younger than 45 years, and 6% in patients under the age of 40. And most of these patients are candidates to receive an anti-cancer therapy that includes the use of chemotherapy. And we know that chemotherapy has several side effects, and one of these side effects in young cancer patients is the possible occurrence of premature ovarian failure, meaning a risk of becoming postmenopausal due to the administration of chemotherapy, and so subsequent risk of infertility. And we know from the literature that approximately 50% of young cancer patients at the time of cancer diagnosis are interested in having a pregnancy after the end of treatment. For all these reasons, a growing attention has been given to the fertility issues of young cancer patients in general in the last years. And particularly for breast cancer patients, to date, there are four different available strategies for fertility preservation that are cryopreservation of embryos, oocyte cryopreservation, cryopreservation of ovarian tissue, and the use of temporary ovarian suppression with the LHRH channel during chemotherapy, that is the strategies that we evaluated in our meta-analysis. Cryopreservation of embryos or oocyte are the standard strategies for fertility preservation in cancer patients. However, they have three main limitations. They require a two-week delay in the start of anti-cancer treatment is needed because they require a contrast ovarian stimulation that lasts between 10 to 15 days to collect the oocytes. They require a surgical procedure, and they can preserve fertility, so the possibility to have babies in the future, but they cannot prevent ovarian function, and so patients are still at risk of developing early menopause. On the contrary, temporary ovarian suppression with LHRH channel during chemotherapy does not require any delay in the start of anti-cancer therapy. Is a widely available option consisting in a single intramuscular injection of a drug given once every month for all the duration of chemotherapy, approximately 5 to 6 months in this patient, and it can preserve both ovarian function and fertility. However, according to international guidelines on fertility preservation in cancer patients, that were the ASCO and ESMO guidelines that were published in 2013, the use of this strategy is still considered experimental. And this is mainly due to the conflicting results of the trials of the randomized trials on this topic available at that time, and the lack of data on long-term outcomes at that time, meaning number of patients achieving pregnancy after treatment and number of patients who develop recurrence of disease during the follow-up. However, in the last year, some important news on this topic have become available, and so we decided to perform a meta-analysis to reassess the role of this strategy, so temporary ovarian suppression with LHRH channel during chemotherapy, as a strategy to preserve ovarian function and fertility of young breast cancer patients. And with the systematic review, we ended up with 12 different eligible randomized studies to be included in our meta-analysis. In these studies, patients were divided in two different treatment arms. In one arm, they received chemotherapy alone, and in the other arm, chemotherapy plus concurrent administration of this drug, the LHRH analog. And these are briefly our results. When pulling all together the data from the 12 studies for a total of 1,200 patients, the use of LHRH channel reduced the number of patients developing premature ovarian failure from 33% to 18%, meaning a 15% reduction in the number of patients developing premature ovarian failure, and the result was statistically significant and clinically relevant. We then restricted the analysis to the trial reporting the number of patients with menses 1 year after the end of chemotherapy, according to the World Health Organization definition of early menopause, of menopause in general, that is absence of menses for 12 months. And again, the use of LHRH reduced the number of patients with 1 year amenorrhea, so patients without menses 1 year after the end of chemotherapy, from 43% to 31%, and the result was again statistically significant. Five studies reported the number of patients with pregnancy, and more patients achieved pregnancy in the LHRH analog arms, 33 patients, than those in the chemotherapy alone arm, 19 patients, and the result was again statistically significant. Finally, only three studies reported number of patients who developed recurrence of disease during the follow-up, and no difference was observed between the two treatment arms, suggesting the safety of the procedure, with approximately 19% of patients in both treatment arms who developed recurrence of disease during the follow-up. And so we conclude that temporary ovarian suppression with the LHRH analog in young breast cancer patients is associated with a reduced risk of chemotherapy-induced premature ovarian failure, so a reduced risk of becoming postmenopausal, and seems to increase the pregnancy rate with no apparent negative consequence on prognosis. And so we believe that the use of these strategies may be considered a valid option for women interested in preserving their ovarian function and may also play a role in increasing the likelihood of becoming pregnant after the end of chemotherapy. And thank you very much for your attention.